Semoga Ustaz selalu dalam lindungan Allah. Amin ya rabbal alamin. Saya mau tanya, apa hukum mendengar musik? Buka fikih, namanya fikih musik. Malam ini kita kaji fikih kurban. Ada buku judulnya fikih musik. Musik itu sama macam cakap. Kalau baik, baik. Kalau tak baik, tak baik. Musik, lagu nasib. Barakallahu lakuma wa baraka alaikuma wa jama'a bainakuma fi khair. Baik, tak salah. Bila Israel datang memanggil, jasad terbujur di pembaringan. Baik, tak salah. Tapi kalau sudah kayak kucing garong, leong racun, cinta satu malam, kabi kaji kabi gam, kucu kucu otahe, datang pula suaminya, haram, tak boleh. Lagu ngajak jihad, Haibar Haibar ya Yahud, Jaisu Muhammad saufa ya'ud, Haibar Haibar ya Yahud. Bangkit semangat anak muda. Khaybar wahai Yahudi, tentara Muhammad akan datang membebaskan Palestina. Bagus, semangat jihad. Apa salah?
Ustaz, saya pernah dengar musik itu haram, tapi saya ragu karena saya suka musik. Tolong penjelasan dalil tentang pengharaman musik. Ini dalil haram musik ya, diantaranya dalam surat Luqman, ya meminan nasi mayasyarilah wal hadithi liyudhila ansabidillah. Di antara manusia ada yang membeli perkataan yang sia-sia untuk menyesatkan dari jalan Allah Subhanahu wa taala. Baca buku tafsir manapun akan disebutkan perkataan Ibnu Mas'ud. Dia bersumpah yang bahwasanya yang dimaksud adalah nyanyian yang menyesatkan orang dari jalan Allah Subhanahu wa taala, ya. Sebagian ulama ya seperti Ibnu Rajab Al-Hanbali dalam kitabnya Fathul Bari, ya, Syarah Sahih Bukhari, ya, versi Ibnu Rajab, dia mengatakan bahwasanya dimaksud dengan nyanyian tersebut adalah nyanyian yang disertai dengan musik. Wallah alam bisawab, ini pendapat beliau karena beliau mengatakan tafsiran tersebut muncul dari Ibnu Mas'ud tatkala kaum muslimin sudah bercampur dengan orang-orang Romawi yang masuk Islam dan kebiasaan mereka adalah menyanyi sambil musik-musikan. Maka ayat ini berkaitan dengan musik, ya. Kemudian dalam hadis dalam Sahih Bukhari Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam mengatakan la yakunana aqwamun min ummati yastahilunal hira wal harira wal khamra wal ma'azif, akan ada dari umatku yang menghalalkan zina, menghalalkan bir, menghalalkan kain sutra bagi lelaki dan menghalalkan alat-alat musik. Ini Rasulullah mengkabarkan akan ada umat yang model begini, menghalalkan zina, yang menghalalkan bir, menghalalkan kain sutra bagi lelaki dan juga menghalalkan alat-alat musik. Ini menunjukkan alat musik hukumnya haram. Oleh karenanya para ulama ijma bahwasanya musik hukumnya haram dan ini pendapat empat mazhab. Dan termasuk ulama yang keras dalam hal ini adalah Imam Syafi'i rahimahullahu taala yang keras mengharamkan musik. Sampai beliau mengatakan kalau ada orang mencuri alat musik maka tidak perlu dipotong tangannya. Ya, tidak perlu. Kenapa? Karena itu hukumnya seperti mencuri babi dan seperti mencuri bir. Sama-sama hukumnya haram. Jadi kalau ada barang karena asalnya barang haram memang apa namanya? Ditiadakan. Oleh karenanya kalau ada yang mencuri alat musik maka tidak perlu dipotong tangannya. Demikian juga beliau mengatakan dalam kitabnya Al-Um, kalau ada orang yang masuk ke rumah seorang muslim, misalnya kemudian dia pun ada orang muslim tersebut punya alat musik, kemudian dia merusak alat musik tersebut, maka dia tidak perlu ganti. Dia tidak perlu ganti. Oleh karena saya sering sampaikan kalau antum pergi ke toko alat musik, antum masuk hancurkan alat musiknya, antum bilang Imam Syafi'i mengatakan demikian. Kalau saya hancurkan tidak perlu ganti. Kata dia tidak usah ganti, tapi tolong masuk kantor polisi ya. Ini pendapat Imam Syafi'i. Oleh karena semuanya, ulama empat mazhab semuanya mengharamkan apa? Musik. Dan kenyataannya musik ya adalah melalaikan. Siapa? Kita semua tahu musik apa? melalaikan. Dan barang siapa yang berusaha beribadah dengan alat musik atau berdakwah dengan alat musik, ya, maka dia telah meniru-niru orang-orang Nasrani. Dan Rasulullah SAW mengatakan, "Man tasyabbaha biqaumin fahuwa minhum." Barang siapa meniru satu kaum termasuk dari golongan tersebut. Orang-orang Nasrani lah yang beribadah dengan menggunakan apa? Alat-alat musik, ya. Akhirnya apa? Ada nada dan dakwah misalnya. Lagi dakwah yang hadir laki-laki perempuan waktu joget-joget. Apakah dengan joget gini nambah iman, ya ikhwan? Pikir sendirilah. Orang joget-joget nambah iman. Nambah teler bukan nambah iman.
Is regarding music. Many Muslims consider music to be allowed. Could you just confirm, did the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam speak against music?
There is a great difference of opinion as far as the Muslims are concerned, whether music is allowed or not, whether it's permitted or not. But there is no verse in the Quran directly prohibiting music, but there are indications. Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Luqman, chapter number 31, verse number 6, it says that among them there are those people who purchase idle tales without knowledge and without meaning, and they mislead the people away from the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they ridicule the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These are the people who will receive a humiliating punishment. So based on this, if you see tafsir, many of the tafsir says that this idle tales without knowledge, without meaning, refers to un-Islamic songs and the musical instruments, if you read the tafsir. As far as the Prophet prohibiting music, there are various sahih hadith. So if you read the hadith of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then there will be no doubt whether it's permitted or prohibited. Our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, it's mentioned in Sahih Bukhari, volume number 7, hadith number 5590. The beloved Prophet said that from among my followers, there will be some people who will make illicit sex, that is adultery and fornication, as well as wearing of silk, drinking intoxicants, and using musical instruments as legal. There will be among my people who will make some things which are illegal, that is adultery, fornication, wearing of silk, having intoxicants, and the playing of musical instruments as legal. Now this hadith, when it says that they will make certain things legal, and we know that intoxicants is haram, we know very well that adultery, fornication is haram, because it is mentioned along with these things which are forbidden, musical instruments are mentioned along with them, it indicates that the Prophet has prohibited them. But some people will make it legal, and we know there are some scholars who today do permit that playing of music instruments is allowed. So this hadith is very clear cut in saying that musical instruments are haram. But there are other sahih hadith which do permit some music instruments, especially the daf, that is the tambourine. If you read the hadith of a beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam of Sahih Bukhari, volume number 5, hadith number 4001, where it is said that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, after consummating his marriage, he came and he sat outside along with one of the sahabas, when two small girls were playing the tambourine, that is the daf, and they were praising that sahaba, his father, how he died in jihad. And when they started praising the Prophet, they said, "Don't praise me, you can say what you were saying earlier," indicating that the Prophet did not prohibit them from playing the tambourine. Furthermore, there is a hadith in Sahih Bukhari, volume number 2, hadith number 987, where the Prophet, while he was lying down, his hadith is narrated by Hazrat Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, she says that two small girls were playing the tambourine and they were singing. When Hazrat Abu Bakr, may Allah be pleased with him, the father of Hazrat Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, he comes and he says to them, "Just stop it." Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sleeping on a cot. He tells to Hazrat Abu Bakr, may Allah be pleased with him, that let them do it. These are the days of Eid. Let them do it. Furthermore, there's a hadith in Tirmidhi, hadith number 3690, where our beloved Prophet Muhammad, he says that there was a person who approaches the Prophet and tells him that I had vowed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that if you come back victoriously, I will sing and I will play the daf. I will bang the tambourine. So the Prophet said, if you have vowed, then do it. If you have not vowed, then don't do it. So these hadith do indicate that musical instrument per se is haram, except for the dafdar, the tambourine. The Prophet did permit sometimes.